What about you?
I'm part of a scavenging team now. But Commander Baron gave us an order to get back to the shelter. If you see Jennifer, can you tell her that?
Okay. Where is she?
The last time I saw her, she was upstairs.
Nice view.
How did you find me?
Patrick told me you might be somewhere around here.
It's my thinking spot. Is he worried?
No, he seems happy. How did he do on your first scavenging hunt together?
Well, at first he was excited just to be outside. A little too excited. Some drones spotted him. But I did it. I managed to protect him. Nothing happened. And from that point on, he understood how dangerous a scavenger's life can be.
See, you'll make a great scavenging team.
Yeah, I'm starting to see it that way. And because of that, I was thinking...
About leaving?
I don't have any secrets from you, do I? Yeah, about leaving. With Patrick.
I think you should leave.
What? Are you serious? I thought you'd be the last person to encourage me to go. What about what you said earlier? What changed?
Things are different now. It's not safe here anymore, and I think you should go.
Jacob, I don't know what to say. You know that your opinion matters to me the most. To be honest, you're the only thing keeping me here. Well, that's it then. I guess I'm going. You're always looking out for me. Thank you for that. I know you're moving out soon, but there's something I want to say. Regardless of what happens later, I hope that we'll find each other. Thank you for always being there for me. I'm lucky to have someone like you.
And I'm lucky to have you.
I hoped you'd say that. You know what? I'll stay here just a little while longer. Tell Patrick not to worry. I'll be back soon.
I'll do that.
You ready to move out?
I am.
All right. Let's do this. Thirty years ago, the machines decided to wipe out all of humanity because they feared that we were a threat to their existence. Today, we make their fear come true. Sergeant Rivers, you were requested by John Connor to lead the Alpha Team. You will be responsible for carrying out the attack on the location of Skynet's central core. We will create a diversion to lure out any HK aerials patrolling the area. That should give you some time to breathe. Taking out Skynet's ground forces, that's on you. Remember, the goal is to destroy Skynet's central core, at whatever cost. Good luck out there. Dismissed.
Alpha, this is Team Bravo. Skynet's taking the bait. Good luck out there.
All right, everyone, this is us. Let's move out. We're 2 minutes out from the observatory. As soon as we get past that barrier, expect Skynet to show up. Stay focused.
Silverfish, 12 o'clock. Neutralize.
Let's keep moving.
Metals ahead.
We're through!
Keep pushing forward!
Rebels!
Good shooting!
More of them! More incoming! Suppressing fire!
Hang in there.
Watch the flame!
Let's
that hill!
Another infiltrator?
No, he's with us.
Took you a while.
How did you know we were coming?
I thought you'd know by now. I know more than you think. Better prepare yourself.
Quiet.
Too quiet.
Spread out! Focus on that HK! They're coming from the west gate! Focus on that HK! They're coming from the west gate! Something's not right!
Follow me. Central Core is downstairs.
How do you know?
I've been here before. I've seen it. Watch out! Skynet's finished. It's not here. The Central Core. It's supposed to be right here. They knew we were coming. They moved it. It's a trap. A fucking trap.
We have to move. Those missiles are headed this way.
Wait! If we triggered the attack, it means that this place is still connected to Skynet's mainframe. If we trace where the signal's coming from, we'll know the Central Core's actual location.
How could they know we were coming?
Skynet was about to lose the war. They sent an infiltrator back in time. He must have warned them about this attack.
How do you know all this?
Because I went back after that infiltrator. Yes! I've got the coordinates. Let's go! All of this will make sense to you soon, but right now we need to go! Commander, Central Core, it's not here. It was an ambush. Commander! You can't die here. Get up! Thank you.
Baron, I've got the coordinates. Can you hear me? Where the hell are you? Commander!
Rivers, you're alive.
What happened here?
An infiltrator got in. Brought lots of friends with him. We didn't stand a chance. Since they didn't go offline, I assume we did not destroy Skynet's central core either.
No. No, we didn't. It was an ambush. They moved it before we got there.
So this is it? We lost? We lost this goddamn war?
Not yet.
What do you mean?
I got the Central Core's real coordinates.
You have? I've got to learn not to doubt you anymore, Rivers.
We need to call Connor. He may still be able to stop Skynet.
Forget it. I couldn't get him on the radio for hours. You need to find him. You need to give him those coordinates.
First, let's get you out of here.
No. You don't have time for this. You have to leave me here.
I can't.
You're not gonna disobey my final order, are you? Before you leave, I've got a confession to make. There's a reason I wasn't so keen on you from the beginning. Remember that list of people Skynet marked for termination? I lied. I told you that you were number three. The truth is, you're number two, just behind Connor. You took my spot, and for the life of me, I couldn't understand why. But now I know. They're coming. You need to leave, now. Use a vent in the command room to sneak past them, and then find Connor, and give him those coordinates. Don't worry about me. If they come here, I'll just reason with them. I still have a couple magazines full of arguments. Now go! Good luck, Jacob.
Thank you.
The stranger died in that ambush trying to protect me. He came from the future to save my life, and I don't even know his identity. But thanks to his sacrifice, I managed to escape with the Central Core's true location. When I got back to the shelter, I realized that getting that information cost the life of many others as well. I headed out to find John Connor and his North Division to take part in the last all-out attack.
Anyone receiving me? This is Sergeant Jacob Rivers, DN46890. Anyone out there? Skynet got to them. If anyone's hearing this, please respond. Is anyone else out there? God damn it.
Look, we got one.
He's wearing a resistance uniform.
Who did you kill to get that, you filthy machine?
No, don't! Wait, he's human!
Sorry about that, Sergeant. The infiltrators took some of our key positions, so we're extra cautious. If we'd known that you were joining us in the North Division, that would have never happened.
You know who I am.
We all do, Sergeant Rivers. John Connor told us about you. He said you'd come and bring those coordinates.
How did he know I'd have them?
That you'll have to ask him yourself. He's waiting for you upstairs.
He's the only survivor from Baron's division.
That's him. The one Connor's been talking about.
Sergeant.
Commander.
Sergeant Rivers. I've been expecting you. I took the liberty of collecting the Central Corps' coordinates you brought us. I hope you don't mind.
Not at all. Are we preparing to attack the Corps?
I've sent a unit to do that. We're getting ready to strike the time displacement equipment. Very soon Skynet will realize that they're losing this war, so they'll try to send infiltrators back in time to prevent that from happening.
Do we stand a chance?
Thanks to the security codes that Mac provided, we've been able to seize control of an HK tank for the first time. It should give us the advantage against Skynet's defense grid. We'll smash it once and for all. I understand that all this might be confusing to you, so if you have any questions, now's the time to ask them.
How did you know that the Central Corps wasn't at the observatory?
Understanding the changing nature of time travel made me anticipate the most unexpected events. So when I learned from a mutual friend of ours that a Terminator was sent back to our time, I suspected the future I was told would change.
What do you mean?
When that infiltrator connected to Skynet, it warned them about the attack on the observatory. They had to move the Central Corps, otherwise they would lose again. Unfortunately, the intel we received came at a cost. But if there was any other way, I would have taken it gladly.
Who is the stranger?
In one alternative future, we reached the time displacement equipment and sent our soldiers back in time. Like always, the mission was to assure the safety of the people Skynet marked for termination. One of whom was you. Knowing the importance of your mission, many volunteered to go back. So I took it upon myself to choose a protector from among them. And the one I chose was you. You are the one you call Stranger.
Why am I targeted for termination?
You're the one who discovered the true location of the Central Core. You're the messenger of the intel that could lead to Skynet's downfall. I'm sure you'll figure out the rest when the time comes. But right now, I want you to get ready. Tonight, soldier, we stop Skynet.
On their way to the Central Core.
Then we better get ready.
Take whatever you need, Sergeant.
Sergeant Rivers, it's time. I want you to take a team of my soldiers and fight your way to Skynet's defense grid. We have to destroy those turrets to get to the TDE, but don't worry. We'll provide the support. It's in your hands now, Rivers. Follow me.
Commander?
Commander?
See it.
Secured.
All right, Rivers. Continue the offensive. We're preparing to send in the tank.
Watch out!
Zero in on that T-47!
Another sector cleared.
That's good to hear, Sergeant. The HK tank just went online.
Aerial!
Down it! T-47 ahead! Two of them!
Sergeant, I got a visual on the defense grid turrets.
Defense grid is smashed! Rivers, status!
We breached the defense grid, Commander.
Good. That HK will accompany you. Proceed forward.
Check your fire! That tank is ours!
This is it! That's the lab they keep the time displacement thing!
Spread out!
There!
Commander. What's going on?
The 124 destroyed the Central Core and stopped Skynet.
So is the war over?
For some of us, yes. But just before we destroyed the Core, Skynet managed to send three Terminators back in time. The only thing in our power now is to send the Protectors to meet them.
Protectors?
The ones that will assure the safety of the people marked for termination. The first Protector has to be Sergeant Kyle Reese. He'll go after the T-800 that's targeting my mother as we speak. By killing her, Skynet will try to erase me from ever existing. The second one will seek to destroy the T-1000.
T-1000?
A Terminator made of memetic polyalloy, sent back to kill me as a child. A single prototype created by Skynet. It's too powerful for a single human being. That's why we'll have to send a Terminator of our own. Do you have that CPU that Mac reprogrammed?
I do. You want to send a Terminator to protect your younger self? Won't you be afraid?
I will be. Then, there's the matter of the infiltrator that was sent after you. The war can end for you right now, but the question is, are you willing to sacrifice your future to protect your past? By being here, you've already proven that this is not beyond your capabilities. But I'll leave the decision up to you.
Will I be able to fix my past mistakes?
I always believe that the future's not set. There's no fate but what we make for ourselves. You do have the power to change it and protect the ones you care about. So, what will it be then?
I'll do it. I'll go back. It's only we can kill it this time around.
Let us begin then.
John Connor prepared the time displacement equipment to send Protectors back in time. He knew that the final battle would not be fought here, but in the past. A Resistance soldier named Kyle Reese was the first man to go back to 1984. His objective was to protect Sarah Connor, John's mother. The second one was not a man, but a Terminator. Using the chip Dr. Mack reprogrammed, we took control of a single infiltrator unit, Cyberdyne Systems Model 101. It was sent back to 1995 to intercept the sole T-1000 prototype and protect a young John Connor. I couldn't have someone risk their life to protect me. That's why I decided to go myself. It gave me a chance to right the wrongs of my actions. After 30 years, this war against the machines is finally over. But not all of us live to see the end of it. We never found Baron's body in the shelter. She never stopped fighting. And if she's still alive, I doubt she ever will. She was the leader we needed in wartime. But I'm not sure if she'll find a place during this time of peace. I lied to Aaron about her husband to make her leave the shelter. I saved her life. But at what cost? Was it my place to intervene and give her false hope? Ryan was kicked out of the shelter because of me. I hope that one day I will have a chance to explain to him why I did that. Jennifer and Patrick left before the attack. I'm glad I convinced her to leave. I hope that our paths will cross sometime soon. Baron asked me to kill Mac, but I couldn't do it. He left soon after my warning, only to be captured by Skynet. We found him alive in one of Skynet's prisons. And as for me, it was time to start over. listen to me if you want to live.